It was heartbreaking for Dominic to see the love of his life get in the luxurious car of this tough, rich guy. He loved her so much. Why didn't she love him back? Was it because he didn't have the car, the nice house, clothes, the money? He didn't quite understand that. But every girl that he had ever loved had refused him. It was devastating. Even the girl that he used to date had left him for someone else, someone richer. Rejection was tough, so Dominic played some loud music and started to paint his pain away. He was in his little apartment looking from the window. Black was the color that he used, all black. But he stopped at a moment and thought, "I can't run from this anymore. I have to do something about it. I know I can do better than this." But he didn't know quite what he could do better. Anyways, he took the new canvas and went to work. On the road, there was a bookseller. He always was there, but Dominic had never paid any attention to books before. This time, though, he saw that there was a sale. $1 books. He saw one with a red color on it that took his attention. The Science of Getting Rich. He stopped for a second and thought if it was a good idea, but he never actually read books, so he just continued walking. The owner put a price of $30 for the new canvas that he had made. He never really said anything about it. It was his shift, so he stood there waiting for someone to come and buy something. If his canvases sold, then he would get much more for that day. A woman came into the store after a little bit. She just wanted something for her living room, something simple. He tried to sell his works, but she laughed and said, "No, dear, that doesn't go with my place. Actually, it looks a little weird and scary." And that was it for him. He was tired of all of that. He wanted to buy some junk food and beer. That was the way that he usually dealt with everything that he couldn't handle. But this time, as he passed by the bookseller, he saw the book still there. He didn't even know how he came to that point, but he actually bought a book this time. He was bored and didn't have many things to do, so he started reading it. Dominic didn't quite understand the ideas in the book, or they looked a little bit mumbo-jumbo to him. He checked out a video online that said that reading the book every day would make you rich. He didn't know what to believe, but there was really nothing to lose, so he decided to do it. He read the book for 6 months straight. Only 1 hour a day was all he could possibly do. Dominic also started practicing the ideas of the book. After 6 months, he got a little bit tired and wanted to give up. 3 days had passed and he didn't even touch the book at all. The next day, a man comes to the store. He doesn't look familiar. He seemed like a traveler. And it turned out he was from Paris. Dominic was so surprised because the man looked quite rich. So he asked himself, what was he doing here? The man was an art collector, so he wanted to check what was available here. Dominic showed him everything, and at the end showed him his own canvases. The man stopped for a second. He didn't say anything, just said that he was going to take that one. That one? His canvas? Wow, said Dominic to himself. He hadn't sold anything of his for months now. What had he seen there? The man asked for the price, and Dominic said, $30, sir. I'm sorry, said the man. $30, sir, Dominic repeated himself. The man laughed and asked who was the artist. Dominic pointed his fingers towards himself. The man then said, how could you sell such a masterpiece for $30? That's insane. Do you have other pieces? Dominic told him that he has some in his apartment that he doesn't even want to see for himself, but the man insisted to see them, and Dominic took him there. He was a little embarrassed about his apartment, and for the pieces that he was about to show him, but the man insisted. The man looked quite astonished. He just kept staring at Dominic and the paintings, looking in awe. After what seemed like an eternity, the man says, "Okay, here's what we're going to do. I have some friends that are doing an exhibition for new talented artists in Paris. Oh, there's also an auction following that. So if you're interested, you can bring the pieces and we'll see how it goes." He also mentioned a price for one canvas that left Dominic speechless. What did he see in his paintings that Dominic and other people who came in the store couldn't see? Before leaving, the man gave him his information and told him that they would be in contact. Dominic saw the paintings hanging all over the place, his book thrown away at one point, and went to his favorite place, the window, and said, laughing hysterically, "Well, I'm rich, I guess."